Yes, my name is Omar Al-Halabi, and I am an assistant professor of GU Medical Oncology at the University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center. My primary interest is in bladder cancer, as well as other genitourinary malignancies. Yes, we'll be happy to. So, the reason we conducted this study is, as it may be well known to the audience, small cell urothelial cancer represents a rare variant of urothelial cancer, representing about around 1% of the whole urothelial cancer population. But it is usually linked to more aggressive behavior, with 90% of patients presenting with invasive disease. Our group at MD Anderson had previously analyzed the outcomes of these patients and had shown that neoadjuvant chemotherapy compared to cystectomy alone showed improvement in these patients' survival, followed by a following paper looking at the different regimens for initial therapy for these patients. And we had our Dr. Arlene Sivker-Ratke had presented and published data about the regimen of cystatin etoposide alternating with ifosfamide and Adriamycin. In this effort, we wanted to, in addition to these chemotherapeutic regimens, wanted to investigate the impact that the approval of immunotherapeutic agents for urothelial cancer had on these patients and their survival outcomes. And how do they compare to the previous era of only chemotherapeutic agents? Yeah, definitely. So the study was a historic retrospective study in Nature. We basically retrieved the patients with urothelial cancer and specifically with the small cell variant in their histology. Using an IRB-approved protocol and analyzed the patients that had metastatic disease. So we ended up with, out of a large cohort of urothelial cancer with small cell histology, which was 275 patients, we ended up with 102 that had metastatic disease. And then we basically classified the patients that never received immunotherapy as part of their management, which was 63 of these patients versus 39 patients that received immunotherapy as part of their management at, of course, either front line or second line treatment, and compared the survival outcomes between the two cohorts. The main result that we found is that patients with who had received immunotherapy as part of their management had an improved or a better median overall survival as compared to the ones that never received immunotherapy, with a median overall survival among the recipients of immunotherapy of 20 around 20 months versus 12 months in the ones that received chemotherapy alone. With a hazard ratio of 0.45 and a p-value of 0.003. Now, this result was a little bit surprising. We, from our experience with the small cell variant of prostate cancer, for example, we don't see such complete clinical benefits to immunotherapy, where this area is still an investigation. But in urothelial cancer, we did see this positive impact of survival. Now, this is, obviously limited by the fact that this is a retrospective and a historic type of study. And possibly this improved outcome might be due to these patients being treated at later years compared to previous years when the standard management overall improved, and the way we deliver care and ancillary services in oncology had improved, and that could have contributed to the improved survival in these patients. But with despite the limitation, this study, although this is a rare variant, and it's difficult to conduct clinical trials in this type of disease, we believe that further prospective studies are indicated to help confirm this finding. In this study are planning to do further analysis in terms of the characteristics of the patients that had achieved a clinical benefit to immunotherapy, whether in regards to their response to therapy or whether it has to do with their survival. And so that analysis is yet to come. But the major takeaway is it does seem that checkpoint inhibitor therapy was associated with improved overall survival for patients with metastatic small cell urothelial cancer. And as I mentioned, it does warrant further investigation in the future.